Okay, it's the end of the month, so here we are with our recap of what we did in April. We worked on six major features, on a bunch of quality of life improvements, and I will also give you some details about what's coming next. So, we worked on native event creation. Basically, before you could only connect an existing Outlook or Gmail calendar account, now you can just create events inside your Evernote account without the need to connect any existing calendar from outside. So this is how it looks like. They can coexist, so you can have both kinds of events together, but this is especially useful for people who just didn't want to connect any account externally. There is also a new task view. Previously, you could only have this task list that's narrow and just doesn't give you a lot of space to look at all the information. Now it looks like this on desktop. It's basically much wider. It gives you a lot of real estate to look at all the metadata and information. You can sort in different ways, and there are new tabs through which you can navigate through your tasks. Especially the notebooks view is new, and now you can see all the tasks that are inside a specific notebook. This way, it's basically as if you had projects for your tasks. And we've also added new fields to tasks. Especially the description field is pretty useful when you need to carry some like context with a task instead of adding it below a task in a note. Now the task carries with itself the context that you need to know about. Another item that we've added is priority. Now, very simple, you can just differentiate between low, medium, and high priority. This is helpful when you need to prioritize a project or what to do in the next day or so. Files section, it's basically a list of files of all the attachments that you've added to your notes. We are still working on this. We want to improve it a lot, but basically what this gives you is a list of files that you can sort in different ways, and you can also filter in different ways. For instance, here you see those two tabs, Media and Docs. It's helpful. It also visualizes them in different ways. And also you can add new files from here. And of course, you have the preview on the right with a big button to open the file in the relative app on your computer, or another little button to navigate to the specific note or notebook, and a button to download the file if you want to save it for other reasons. There is a new import feature as well. We've added the possibility to add notes by converting existing docx, HTML, text, or markdown files, as well as some information about how to import content from Apple Notes, Microsoft Word, Google Docs, and other apps. And then the new mobile home. So we've made a whole video about this. You can check it out. I will not go through all the variations that we worked on, but basically we took the mobile home. It was very messy, very hard to understand, especially for new customers. We wanted to simplify this a lot, and so we've built this. This is the new mobile home. It's out for everybody on version 10.86. And the reason why we did it is basically to focus on the value of mobile, which is capturing stuff very quickly, making search more accessible. So we brought down the search button and extended it, as well as faster navigation. Earlier, you needed to go through the hamburger menu, and now you can just tap on different sections on that nav bar. And yeah, so these were our goals. Let's talk briefly about quality of life improvements. So we've developed this new header link feature that allows you to copy with a little button a link to that specific title. This means that you can paste it in a note, in the same note, in another note, or in another software, like on chat, for instance, and share that note with the context of that title. Especially useful if you have a long note and you need to refer to a specific section. This is useful when paired with table of contents. So the table of contents is something that you can add through the slash menu, and it just creates a list of the titles that you have inside the note that basically resemble the structure of the note itself. By clicking on each item, you will be scrolled to that specific section. And there are new slash commands. We've brought headings, large, medium, and small header, and checklist, bullet points, and numbered lists. We've brought them to the slash menu. These you could also do earlier, previously, but you either needed to remember the keyboard shortcut or to navigate with the mouse through the toolbar. Now they are like one slash away. This is the power of the slash menu. You can just hit slash and have a list of things that you can insert. Let's also talk about what's coming soon. So one of the main questions that we've received lately is, what about mobile and tablet? Like, have you forgotten about those? So our process, in order to be faster at iterating and trying to understand better what things bring value and what don't, which is not always clear, we develop first on desktop, we release something, we conduct our research and we ask people how they are finding new features. If we get them right at the first try, that's good, we're all happy. If we don't, as sometimes happens, we try to work again on those. And so for this reason, it does make sense to work simultaneously on both desktop and mobile. So some of the next few weeks will be dedicated to bringing some of these features to mobile and tablet as well. Here you see some examples, probably there will be more. Calendar event creation, task metadata, collapsible sections, and table of contents, they are all coming to mobile and tablet too, together with probably some other features as well. And this is going to be an important time investment, but we're also adding new things like pinned notes to notebooks. Now you will just be able to pin a note to a notebook and always see it up there, and tasks in calendar. Now you will be able to see tasks inside your daily view. This is useful because when you're planning a day, you don't just want to see your events or your meetings, but you also want to see what stuff you need to get done that day. Lastly, we have a nice little one. It's a bit more a niche feature, but for those who need it, this is a game changer. We are bringing syntax highlighting to code blocks. Actually, we are rewriting the whole code block feature that you can add to a note. Together with that, we are also bringing syntax highlighting to the code block. And yeah, this is it. Thank you for watching, and see you next month.